Good morning, students. How are you? So today we are going to do our next chapter, that is nouns, singular and plural. So the pronunciation is singular, not singular. Okay. So as you have done, change the number. This is as it is. Okay. It is called change the number also, which you have done earlier. So this is. A noun can refer to one or more than one person, animal, place or things. Can you see the noun? You know, remember, a noun is the name of a person, animal, place and a thing. So here what we learn, that when we change, like when we change singular into plural terms, okay, so we change the number. Like for example, we'll see one by one. First we'll see of person. Okay, a noun that names one person, animal, place or thing is called a singular noun. If we talk about one thing, that is a singular noun. Okay, so here you can see, if we talk about a person, an animal, a place or a thing, remember, if you are talking about one noun, so that is a singular noun. Okay, like here you can see the examples one by one. It's an example of a person, that's a boy. Then an animal, that is a cat. Then a place, that is a house. Then a thing, that is a flower. So these are the singular, okay, singular noun. Now, but a noun that names more than one person, animal, place or thing is called a plural noun. Okay, we'll talk about two persons, two animals, means more than two animals, the more than places, two places, and then things also. Like boys, you can see there are three boys in this picture. So we will not say a boy, we'll say boys, three boys. Here you can see that there are three cats. So we'll add s in the noun while making plural of it. See here, house. If we talk about place, that is houses. If we talk about plural form, like here, two flowers are there. You can see there are two flowers because we are talking about plural noun. Okay, so whenever we make plural of one noun, so that we have to add s. Okay, there are some other rules also that I'm going to tell you later on. First I'm showing you live examples, some live. Okay, so here is it. What is it? This is a dog. Okay, this is a dog, which is an animal. So we'll say this is an animal. Okay, so here if we talk about lots of animals, so we'll say animals. These are animals. So for one we use animal, for one we use animal, and more than one we'll say there are four, so we'll say these are animals. So animals. Okay, so I'll give the other example, that is when we talk about one man. So we'll say the spelling is M-A-N, man. But if we talk about more than one man, that is here you can see two mean other. So the spelling will be M-E-N, not M-A-N-S. No, we will not add S, we will say M-E-N. So this is these are irregular nouns. So I'm going to tell you here we have added S, animal, and then animals, we have added s. Okay, but when we talk about man and when we make the plural of it, that will be the different spelling, that is men, we have not added s. So these are the irregular. So I'm going to tell you the rules of these nouns, so I hope you listen carefully. So here are the rules. The first rule is we have to add es at the end to the noun. The word which ends which that ends in by ch, s h o s s s, that is double s, x and z, to get their plural forms. For example, here you can see ostrich. At the end, ch is there. So what we add? Then we will add es, ostrich, ostriches. Now the next is, you can see I told you that if there will be an o at the end of the noun, then we have to add s. Okay, so next is ox, oxen, not oxes. Okay, so don't write oxes. The plural of ox is oxen. Mostly students write oxes, but that's wrong. The nouns, this is the second rule, that the nouns that end in a consonant followed by y change into plural form by adding ies. Like here you can see city, cities. We have to drop the letter y and then we have to add ies. Here also country, countries. We have to drop y. Okay, cut y and then write down ies instead of y. But here monkey, monkeys, you don't have to write like this. This will be a wrong answer. So what you have to do is you have to add only s. Monkey, monkeys. Why? So here is it, your answer. The nouns that end in a vowel followed by y change into plural form simply by addition s. Like monkey, monkeys. Key, keys. Okay, you can see e vowel is there. So this is the answer. Now to form the plural of a noun that ends in f or fe, we have to replace f or fe and add ves. For example, leaf. Instead of if, we have to add ves, leaves. Okay, leaf, one leaf, and lots of leaves. A few words, this is the next rule, that a few words do not follow the rule. They don't follow the rule. Like chef, chefs. So here you can see only s has been added here. Okay, so the next rule is, some nouns have the same form in singular and plural too. Like sheep. Okay, so the plural of sheep will be sheep, not sheeps. Okay, now next is your hair. The plural of hair will be hair, not hairs. It will be hair only because it is uncountable. We cannot count hair. Can you count here? No. So here the plural of hair will be hair. Now bison, the plural of bison will be bison. Fish will be fish. Now irregular nouns that do not form plurals in the usual way. So I had given you the examples. Now a few singular nouns form their plural by changing the inside vowel or vowels. So example I had given you earlier, remember? Man, min. So I had given you example of this, live example I had given. Man, min, tooth, tooth, teeth. So instead of double O, we have used double E. The plural of tooth is teeth. As it is, there are so many examples like child, children. So these are the examples. Now we will come to exercises. So this is your first page of chapter number 4 in grammar book, that is nouns singular and plural. So here you can see on the left side it is written singular, you have to write plural on the right side. So these are the examples which I have already shown you, that bus, buses, cat, cats. Okay, so now here there is a list of nouns and their plurals have been written. Like first is by adding s, by then second is by adding es, then ies, third. So all these six I have told you, I have explained you with pictures. So I hope you will learn it. Okay, when you learn it, then you will do this exercise. So this is your homework. There are two questions, A and B. So what you have to do is, if you are having book, so do it in book. Otherwise, you can use Doodle also, and or you can write in the notebook, okay, as well. So singular, the words which has been which have been written in the left side, that are in singular noun, that is, that are singular nouns, and you have to make it plural nouns. Thank you.